Welcome to today's edition of the Lord Mayor's City Hall Concert Series. My name is Angie West, and I'm one of the co-producers of this series, and it is such an honour and a privilege to be able to present this concert to you today. I would like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land on which we're gathered today for this celebration of a very special person and pay my respects to our elders past, present and emerging. The wonderful Annie Lee, one of Queensland's famous Kransky sisters, was to have travelled from Melbourne to perform today. Donald was a dear friend and colleague, but of course lockdown means that she's not here and we are thinking of her today. Donald was a very welcome and beloved part of this concert series for over two decades, and it's my great honour and privilege again to have been able to help the members of Fool's Errand put this concert together, and I hope so much that you enjoy this beautiful memorial and tribute to Donald Hall.
Yes, and welcome to this special tribute concert for Donald Hall. For those of you who hadn't known, Donald passed away earlier this year at 1 a.m. on January 21st. And many of you will have known him through the concerts here, and many of you will have known him as a friend. We hope for all of you that you will find out a little bit more about this amazing man through the music he loved, the excellent artists who gathered around him, some of the music he composed as well, as many of the facts about his life as we can gather into this little window of time, and we all hope with a good shimmering of foolishness, but more of that later. So without further ado, Donald said, give me the music. Music was vitally important for him. So here's a true story of Donald as a young boy listening to the radio. And on the radio, they were playing a waltz. And from that moment on, Donald Hall loved waltzes. And this one on the radio, this one in particular, inspired him for life. In fact, it inspired his life. It's called The Artist's Life.
Thank you.
The Artist's Life by Johann Strauss, of all people. I'd like to introduce Karen Crone to give us a glimpse into this artist's life.
Donald Lindsay Hall, 1953 to 2021. Today we celebrate the many gifts we have all received from Donald Hall, our dear, dear friend with the fabulous smile. I would like to acknowledge his sister Jenny Borello, who is here with us today. Donald Hall was born in far north Queensland in the Mariba Base Hospital on the 18th of November 1953. One of identical twins, he and his brother Greg, sister Jenny and their parents lived in the small community of Normanton, way up north in the Gulf of Carpentaria. Mariba was the closest hospital to Normanton at that time. Although beginning his musical education on a piano accordion, given to them by an opera singer aunt who had gone deaf, Donald moved to piano and violin, finally studying cello at the Queensland Conservatorium, as well as acquiring degrees in psychology, anthropology, and music therapy. He loved learning, and he continued that romance throughout his life. Upon graduating, Donald went into the public health system to become the first music therapist to work in public hospitals in Queensland. Along with his colleagues, they organised several national conferences and established a full course in music therapy at the University of Queensland. After this, he moved into the theatre, which he went on to consume a major part of his career. Many of us here today, in the audience and on the stage, met Donald through the theatre and, of course, through our shared love of music. For 20 years, he was the music director for Brian Nason's celebrated touring Shakespearean company, Grin and Tonic. Donald performed frequently as a solo pianist in recitals at the Queensland Performing Arts Centre, where he had the distinction of performing solo more than any other artist in the 20th century. He came to the harp through theatre, having composed the score for the Queensland Theatre Company's 21st anniversary production of The Epic of Gilgamesh. The reviews were so overwhelmingly favourable that he began playing the harp more frequently, taking it to theatre, opera, ballet and concert stages. With some of the musicians on this stage today, Donald began exploring early Spanish classical music. You'll hear some of this later in the concert. He used the chromatic harp to great effect in his beloved Kadir and Noor ensembles, performing traditional and classical Persian music. The repertoire played by these two ensembles was one of the only places in the world where you could hear the full complement of Persian instruments. Donald taught for many years at the Queensland University of Technology, working in the music and drama departments. He always became totally engrossed by the shows that we worked on, and he would often don a character himself. I can hear Donald greeting our company of students with, "Up on your trotters, angels, up on your trotters." Students adored Donald. We worked together on many shows as director and musical director. Tommy was his all-time favourite. Immediately we started work on Tommy, I requested a pinball machine be found for the centrepiece of the show. Of course, someone in the crew put their hand up and we had a pinball machine. The crew, as crews do, inevitably got the high score. And when they did, it played Pinball Wizard. Ah, the magic of Donald. Being with Donald was being in the presence of magic. We had so much fun working with those students on those shows. Not only would he teach them, he would also cook for them and educate them in the etiquette of parties. Donald had a reputation for throwing the most fabulous theatre parties. His parties would celebrate his favourite companions, Beethoven, Mozart, Shakespeare, and the Titanic. Students would be expected to prepare a party piece, which would be performed during the festivities. His famous Titanic parties would have guests arriving with intricate cakes depicting the sinking of the Titanic. This followed by rehearsed demonstrations of the sinking of the Titanic played out in the bath. He had a large number of scale replicas for this purpose, only to be topped by a Titanic-sized game that had party participants enthralled with playing to survive. It was hilarious. Donald would go to great lengths preparing and hosting these parties. He would investigate the menus from the Titanic for both steerage and first class. He would then replicate these splendid dishes, all made vegetarian, of course, for the revellers to enjoy. Donald's parties were truly second to none. He was just the best fun to be around, always so naughty and irreverent. And like moths to a flame, he became a desired muse for so many creatives. He was incredibly generous with his time, encouragement, knowledge, friendship, love, and support. More often than not, when you would visit, you would find Donald already holding court or playing something magical on one of his many instruments in his carefully arranged, ornate, beautiful, shrine-laden, ever-welcoming home. It was like looking through a looking glass. He produced CDs, a book of Persian literature, as well as a number of plays and cabaret shows. Donald received awards for his contribution to music in the areas of theatre, therapy, and the community. He was a much valued member of the Stairwell Project, playing his harp for staff and patients at the Royal Brisbane Hospital. To walk into the foyer of RBH and hear the heavenly sounds of Donald playing his harp must have been pure magic for so many, many people. For over 20 years, he was a regular and beloved part of the Lord Mayor's City Hall concert series. The mastery of his instruments, his passion, and his unique ability to create an immediate rapport with audiences endeared him to thousands of music lovers. We all will miss you, Donald. Your life therapy, your rambling philosophical discussions, your scholarly knowledge, your fine musicianship, your devilish smile and wit, and your beautiful friendship. You were a true artist in so many ways. Love you, Donald. Thanks for everything. We are all so much richer for knowing you.
One of Donald's close musical associates, Annie Lee, would have been here to perform some songs for us today, but is in lockdown in Melbourne. Annie is one of the Kransky sisters, and she is also an exciting solo cabaret performer. She has sent us her tribute to Donald, which I will read to you. I've known Donald Hall since my college years at Kelvin Grove began in 1985, where he was our musical director. We instantly hit it off and became close friends. Donald was my mentor and an ongoing source of inspiration to me throughout the years. Cherished memories of the excitement and laughter we shared while writing together on his beautiful veranda in his backyard jungle will stay with me until my own passing. I loved him dearly, as we all do. I'm so sad that I can't be with you all today to share and celebrate his life. An inimitable soul with his unique talent, his amazing knowledge and very wicked sense of humour. We are all blessed to have known him. Thank you, Annie Lee.
Thanks, Prue. And thank you, Karen, and amazing photos, don't you think? Fantastic. I'd like next to introduce our special choir, which we have prepared and conducted by the infamous Errand Murphy. This is an a cappella piece written around 1998 by none other than Donald Hall. Kyrie eleison, composed especially for Errand's original group, Quired, and recorded back in 98.
Here we go.
Hey, a special choir just for this concert. Thank you, Errand, so much. We'll go on to this piece. Where you go, Nicole? This is another waltz. It's called The Eve of All Hallows, and it's composed by Donald Hawke. We love this piece, but watch out, it gets wicked at the end. So last year, do you remember last year? I can't remember last year. Donald's group, Fool's Errand, was booked to play in this very spot. But we all know what happened. We hope it doesn't keep on happening. We hope it ends soon. So Fool's Errand, why is it called Fool's Errand? It's so called because at one stage when they were playing in Donald's room for weeks and months and months and months,
years.
Staying in Donald's room, the guitarist Tom Adney said, "We'll never get out of this room. This is a fool's errand." We've got out of the room. So in Clon's witty wise way, this concert was dedicated to two of his life themes, and it's themes that he'd learned because he was a fantastic scholar of Shakespeare. And these two themes are the joy to be found in realizing our human folly, and the joy to be found in beauty. So music from the courts of folly and beauty. So we begin with another waltz by Donald Hall. Try dancing to this, I challenge you. it's more of a folly than a waltz. Right. There are specific tempos marked, which I think I have to read to you because we need to observe them very strictly. The first tempo marking is Un poco wombat. Further down, it's got a marking which says, Tutti molto wombat Viennese. Now, it's important to note that Donald was very serious about acoustic music, or very passionate about it. He had theories how the acoustic music would have an impact on all of our bodies. So, given that, here we go. So, because I knew Donald wanted this concert to be all about folly and beauty, I foolishly told him that I'd written this fool poem. He foolishly said, "We'll have that with the foolish Eric Sartee." I thought I wisely said, "It's a bit of a risk, maybe not." They foolishly asked me to keep it in. I foolishly said, "All right." Sati Nosium. The poem, I better do the poem. Yes, in the name of folly, here it is. When the fool was young, he wandered off alone. At 5 years old, a hermit, not a worry in his head. There was there's a beach nearby and a path of sand. He padded on the path, I said he padded on the path beside the dune grass. The dunes grew high around him and the sound of waves dim. Of his padding fascinated him. The path leads to a summit, yes, it leads unto a summit. Way up high there is a summit, there must be a sort of summit somehow, somewhere. The path led to a summit, yes, it led unto a summit. It led right up to a summit, and he stood upon the summit. In the sun there. It felt absolutely right that he should do so. He said, I choose so. He was all of sky and all of light and knew so. Eventually they found him. They were angry at that child. Fearful of his folly, being foolish all this while, but he was thinking. Yes, when they took him back, he was thinking of that light and wanting to return there. Nobody wants to know. can see he's just a fool, and he never gives an answer. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round. Yes, Donald's taste reached all the way from the Beatles to everywhere, actually. You get an incredible sense of his reach of interest. Now, I'd like to point out that Nicole will play two harps in this concert, and they're both made by master harp maker Brandon Lascelles here in Queensland, and I think Brandon is actually somewhere in the audience. So, Donald worked closely with Brandon in the innovation and design of these instruments. And Donald also wrote a complete history of the instrument and a complete playing technique for this very rare instrument. This one in particular is modeled on the Pleyel harp of the late 1800s. And Nicole will play one of Donald's many all-time favorites, Carrick Fergus. That's beautiful. Nicole and I were coming in this morning and we were saying, how many harps did Donald have? And we worked out it was nine. Nine harps. It was another one somewhere along the line, but nine, we decided, nine harps. Can I introduce to you the incomparable flautist, Rhonda Davidson? So, she's here to do a Celtic set that she used to do with Donald. It's three pieces. Hash plant, Paddy White, and high heel. No. Ash plant, Paddy White, and high heel. real.
Thank you.
Someone I haven't introduced to you, someone I haven't introduced to you is Danielle Bentley here, sitting by my side on the beautiful cello. She shared with Donald many moments in the early music concerts that he did. I'd also like to invite Sharon Moore, the beautiful soprano, to the stage. Thank you very much, Sharon Moore. Listen, I hope you're getting a glimpse of the diversity of Donald's musical world. So we're going back in time here, and Sharon's here to sing the timeless, absolutely timeless, Purcell Dido's Lament.
Oh, my poor son.
That's another one we love and Donald loved especially. Donald kept on going further back in time. This is Siavash Aryan, who shared with him the exploration of the Persian music. And he kept on going back to the Renaissance. So we're talking 1500s here to the Spanish Renaissance. And this whole new world opened up where his beloved cross-strung harp could find a new place. Nicole is now going to play a different harp. It's called the Southern Cross Harp. It's another one by Brandon. It's smaller and suits this more ancient Spanish Renaissance world. I should also point out that Nicole is Don Hall's singular protege on this rare cross-strung harp. He was her mentor and left her with his passions about the harp. She's had to fill Clon's shoes with all this new repertoire, and we couldn't have done it without her. Here to catch this special era, Siavash Aryan on the daf, which is a beautiful Sufi instrument, isn't it? Sufi drum. Andrew Vivas on guitar. Amazing Andrew Vivas.
Thank you.
a quick La Folia, known as The Folly by Martinet. La Folia, The Folly. I'd like to invite Prue Gibbs, another fantastic friend of Donald's, a very old friend of Donald's, to come to the piano for our final piece. Prue Gibbs, everyone. Sadly, we'll leave you today. We leave you sadly today, actually. We'll leave you with a man who was central to Donald's life and indeed his whole outlook on life. Mozart. Mozart was the ultimate for Donald. And I can try a few guesses as to why. Mozart's music has a childlike joy, and at the same time, it has a perfect and sublime beauty in its expression. And I like to think that Donald was like Mozart in his way. He was so light. He was so joyful. And he was so sublime with his fine, fine wisdoms and his fine, fine wit. We'll leave you with the sublime motet of Mozart's Ave Verum Corpus, written 6 months before his death. You'll hear the words, Esto nobis, pre gustatum in mortis examine, meaning for us, before us, a foretaste of the heavenly banquet after this trial of death.
Ave, 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 Ave.
Thank you, everyone, so much for being here to share this incredibly special day. I would like to say a very special thank you to Brisbane City Council for their support for this show, to you, Janie, to Nicole, to Eugene, to Karen, and to Erin, especially for being part of the team that helped me put this together. Would not have happened without you. To every single person on the stage, to beautiful, good company, the choir. Hans, thank you, and Julian, for the beautiful sound today. Thank you for sharing this with us, everyone. The ushers will be by to take to show you out of your seats, if you could remain seated until they show you the door. Thank you so much. But again, absolutely stunning. Donald, legend. I noticed that there was a spare seat right in the middle of the choir that didn't get filled, and I think he was with us sitting there on stage today. So much love to everyone here on stage, to all who knew and loved Donald. Thank you so much.